Hey guys, welcome to part 2 of Vlogmas. Within the Vlogmas. So today's first day that she is going to be ridden since May. So she's had a really, really long break just simply because I haven't had the time because I was doing my horticulture course. So yeah, now it's the first day back. So my plan for today is that I'm going to take her for a ride now in a few minutes. So I'm going to film my grooming routine with her and tacking up and all that. And then I will try and get a little clip of her, you know, from the aspect of on her back. And that's very dependent on Shanti. If she's too fresh, obviously, because it is her first day back, I'm not gonna, you know, do that. Hey guys, welcome to VoiceOver Me. So I decided to record a voiceover with fact file about Shanti for this section of the vlog. So Shanti's story started with us when we bought her unseen in June of 2015. She was a just-backed 4-year-old, and I have to say, when we first saw her, we were a little bit shocked as she was quite underweight. So at that point, I lightly rode her for around 3 weeks before turning her away to allow her to mature. I then brought her back in on that following September to restart her from scratch. She was very honest, and her coping mechanism when she feared anything was to bolt rather than rear or buck. This particularly came to light when I took her out on the road for hacks, because she was terrified of any car or van or anything that was a vehicle, really, even if it stopped and slowed down and turned off the engine. So she would panic and bolt if she had to come near one. So I did a lot of in-hand work, walking her in-hand, just to get her used to the idea that it was okay, she didn't need to panic. And now at this point, she's really good. She just stops and waits for the car to pass her. So Shanti is probably best at jumping. She's quite scopey. She is very keen coming to a fence, so she'll literally pull you to a fence. She will flick over and do her flying changes if she lands wrong. So I haven't show jumped her a whole lot because I don't really do show jumping. I haven't got the weight to do it. The other thing about Shanti is that she adores the beach. So I have only brought her again a handful of times, and every time she just comes absolutely alive. She really fast, really keen, never spooks at anything. She just opens up big time. So I guess that kind of brings us up to today. So Shanti is a 14-2 Connemara Cross sports mare by Parkmore Bobby, and she is now 8 years old.
Rockin' around the Christmas tree, have a happy holiday.
Shanty. We just went for a 15-minute walking hack. She was really, really good, actually, considering it was her first ride back. I was surprised. What I'm actually going to do is I'm going to untack her. I am going to then brush her off, and then I will... I don't know that I can, but I'll try and get it on camera. So I'm going to try and tidy up her mane, tidy up her tail, do her bridle path, forelock, and all that kind of thing. So, talk soon. Okay, so guys, so when I'm pulling manes or tidying up a mane, I generally use a tool dependent on the thickness of the mane. So at the moment, Shanty's mane is quite thin. It's not really thick, so I'm not going to pull it because pulling it will only thin it further, nor am I going to thin it. What I am going to use is the solo comb. It's a really, really handy tool, especially for a young horse when you're trying to pull their mane and they don't like it so much. So it's really, really handy. And basically what the solo comb does is you back comb, same as you do when you're pulling, and then you press this little lever and a blade shoots across. It just cuts the mane. So the finish probably isn't as nice as it would be if you were using the pulling comb, but I'm not going to pull her mane because it's just too thin. And she'll have no mane left at all. And I do love a good mane. So I use the scissors just to tidy up the ends, to cut the bridle path, to trim the ears if I can, and also to trim the tail.
Try as we stop. rocking around the Christmas tree, let the Christmas spirit ring.
If you've any questions, drop them below. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed.
Just see those sleigh bells jingling, ring, tingle, tingling.